Yo, what is up there, guys? It's Mothership checking in, and I'm playing some Heart of the Swarm beta here. And yeah, I'm going to be playing a 1v1 because some people are requesting it, and I haven't done it in a while, so I figured it'd be fun. For those of you wondering where we've been, me and SC Infester, we've been studying for finals and stuff, and I've been sick. I've actually been sick throughout my finals, so it's been kind of unfortunate for me, but oh well, that's life. And yeah, actually I did pretty darn good in my final, so not a big deal there. Also been taking SAT subject tests while sick. Not so confident in those, but once again, that's kind of life. Haven't been playing too much Starcraft because of that. You can see my bonus pool is pretty darn high. But yeah, I'm gonna be playing a 1v1, so here we go. This is on the Hardest Swarm beta once again. Gonna be playing Protoss. I have messed around with the other two races a little bit, but once again, Protoss is just the race that I'm best at, and I have more fun when I'm winning, so I like to play Protoss. Also, I'm just more comfortable with them, and I'm kind of enjoying the new mechanics that Protoss has in Heart of the Swarm. It makes it a bit more exciting, and you have a lot more versatility in the earlier stages of the game as Protoss, which is really fun, at least for me. I'm really enjoying it. Yeah, so we'll see what matchup we get. I really hope I get T or Z, or I play against a T or Z, because I've got some cool new openings with slight subtle variations that are kind of really well timed out, I think. We'll see if I'll be able to execute them well, because like I said, I haven't played in a while, so my execution might be kind of poor. Okay, cool, so we got a PvT. For those of you wondering what I'm going to be doing here, when I talk about kind of well-timed early executions, is that basically I'm going to get a Mothership core out really quick, and a really quick Stalker with a Zealot. There's actually been a recent Reddit, or not Reddit post, but a recent article about this opening that was placed on Reddit, but was not written on Reddit. Anyways, that kind of goes into really, really good detail on exactly how to do this opening. But basically the idea is that you get this Stalker and this Zealot out really quickly along with the Mothership Core. The Mothership Core goes into the main, and it allows you to get either a good Scouter or potentially even kill some probes and marines. It's just a really strong opener all around. It's pretty much a relatively standard one gate expand, just incorporating that Mothership Core in and getting it out a little bit quicker. You delay Warp Gate just a little bit, but you don't really need it that quickly anyways in this matchup now that you've got the Mothership Core, because it's really good against Marines, and this early on, you don't really have to worry about too heavy of Marine pushes, because you can always just use that Energize Overcharge or whatever ability. And the Mothership Core can fly and shoot down, so Marauders aren't really that big of an issue, and Reapers can be kind of a trouble, just because they can fly in, use your Energize, and they just fly away. I don't know why I'm building at the front like that, but whatever. My probes are under attack. Get this Assimilator out. Gonna wound the SCV and then run away and recharge shields, and then I can potentially kill this SCV if he doesn't do anything about me. We'll see. I think he was considering putting it on a command center. We'll see though. All right, here we go. Ah, so close. Oh well. Let's see what he's got underneath the hood. Get that Cybernax core out. Canceling that probe just because it wasn't necessarily needed to be queued up just quite yet. Get the Zealot out ASAP. And then we'll go ahead and throw down another pylon so we don't get supply blocked. So we get the chance here. Just like that. Ooh. And we'll go ahead and take this watchtower in a moment. Alright, so like I was saying earlier, the idea is that we kind of delay warp gate for just a moment. We'll go ahead and chrono boost these out. Oh no. Oh well. It's fine. Alright, let's do it. So I generally like to put the Stalker and Zealot on 1 and then the Mothership Core on 3. Don't forget Warp Gate, because that is something that I typically do forget. And throw down that Nexus. The Nexus is a little late, which is kind of unfortunate, but... oh well, better late than never, at least. And we'll get another pylon down there. Alright. So actually in Cloud King, this is pretty cool, because we can harass here at the front, and then the Mothership Core can come in from this angle over here. And I'm going to throw down 2 gateways, and then get the Assimilator here. So we'll apply pressure here at the front, and oh wow, he actually hasn't expanded, which is a little odd. The question becomes, why not? Wow, okay, so he's going for a lot of Marines. This is what I'm talking about, you can apply a lot of pressure here. Okay, I'm going to get another gateway then. Then I should probably get a Robo out. But it's almost like he's just going for pure Marine. He's got double gas though, so... Oh, I almost want to say Banshees. I don't know though. It could be. There's no reason for why he... couldn't. Uh-oh. Oh god. See, this is bad now. Now that I've done... okay, well, we're gonna recall that back. Research complete. What has he got? Okay, so he's going for tank. He's actually pulling a couple of... And I don't have enough energy for overcharge. So, I could have just shot myself in the foot by, having recalled the Mothership Core, but it probably would have died. Alright, we're gonna have to retreat to the high ground, but this is alright. So yeah, this guy's totally all in. So it's a good thing that we did kind of give up the Nexus there. Otherwise, yeah, we would have been in Pound Town, USA. Where's that? Oh, I could have sworn I built a pylon, but I guess I didn't. Got that Banshee. Everyone retreat. Getting intense.
Reinforcing silence.
of the Banshee though. Oh, come on. Oh, well. You win some, you lose some. So now he's probably expanding behind this. He's gonna have that kind of time. So many banshees. I hate banshees so much. Cold is the void. Not enough energy. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna try and break this, alright? Oh, nope, not yet. State thy bid. Direct us. Ki Nala Atum. Alright, patience is a virtue, my friend. Oh, damn, I could have used this guy so long ago. That would have made a big difference, actually, if I had gotten this pylon down way earlier. Anyways, my goal is this. We're gonna warp in here at the bottom. Alright, that will maybe distract him, hopefully. What the hell's going on over here? Damn it, how did he know? What the fuck? How did he know? That kind of sucks. Alright. Okay. You must construct additional pylons. My life for life.
My meditation is life. I am the voice of the eclipse.
Okay. Alright.
Guide us, as all are one. We await.
Break the line, man. Charge of the Light Brigade. Down. Very well. Oh god, save the probe, save the probe. Well, that was fun. So many mortals. For these guys,
we stand as Na'adan Atu. I return to
serve. Okay, let's go. He's gonna be totally prepared for this. Probably have bunkers for days. Yep. Oh no, I hit the wrong button. I hit the wrong button. Oh god, I hit the wrong button. Let's just get in the production line. Hey, there we go. We did it, guys. Woo! could have been handled a little bit better. There's a lot of different approaches I could have taken to that situation. Oddly enough, probably if I'd gone... I want to say if I'd gone Phoenix's pretty early on, because he was so dedicated to gas, that his marine production was probably pretty low to get that first tank out pretty quickly, even though... Even though at first, initially, he's going to have, like, kind of a pretty good size number of Marines, because a lot of his minerals are going to be sunk into Marines. As he's starting to get those Banshees out really quickly, and that Raven, and then reinforcing tanks, and he's building up bunkers, his Marine count's going to get pretty diminished. So if I'd gone Phoenixes, I could have picked up tanks pretty easily and dealt with the Banshees really easily, and then probably just gone, like, Zealot Stalker. Maybe even potentially gone into Robo Bay as well, but... that seemed to have worked out pretty well, too. Yeah, so that was fun, guys. Hopefully, you enjoyed that. I know most people like to see custom games, so I'm going to go ahead and do a couple of custom games as well. For your entertainment. If you guys really want to watch me 1v1 more on my live stream, there's like hours upon hours of recorded video of me just 1v1ing, listening to music, stuff like that, chatting with the audience. So you guys can go check out that video or the VODs there. That's at twitch.tv/scmothership. You might even catch me live. On the left-hand side, you can see the last time that I streamed, so you can get an idea of how frequently I stream and whatnot. It's generally not too frequently, but sometimes I go on spells where, like, I'll stream every day for a weekend and, like, a couple days into the week or whatever, and then I'll just, like, not stream for, like, a week or two. I don't know. I'm kind of random whenever I stream, but, yeah. Anyways, guys, enough of me meandering on. SMSHIP checking out. And once again, sorry about the nasally congested sounding voice. I'm sick. Deal with it. Bye.